When you first create a pivot table in Excel, the pivot table layout should resemble this one. The row headings are all in the same column, so in this case, that's the associate name and the dates. The subtotals are at the top of each of the groups, and the grand totals are showing for both the rows and columns. These are all characteristics of the pivot table compact form layout option and is the default pivot table layout in Excel. To see the other pivot table layout options, make sure that your active cell is somewhere inside your pivot table, and this will bring up the pivot table tools options menu. If you click on this, you'll see two tabs, the Analyze tab and the Design tab. The report layout options will be in the Design tab in the Layout section under Report Layout. The other two report layout forms are the Outline form and the Tabular form. The outline form separates each field into its own column by hierarchy, like an outline would, and displays the subtotals for each item above the data for that group. Also notice how the headings used to say row labels and column labels. Let me undo this. So row labels and column labels, and they now reflect the field name. The tabular form also displays each field in its own column, but it moves the subtotals to beneath the data for each group and labels them more clearly as totals. When you use the outline or tabular forms, you have the option to repeat your row headers for each item. This is a good idea if you have a lot of rows of data that might make it confusing as you scan down the report. But for a small sample like this one, it's not necessary, and I think it makes the report look a bit cluttered. Next, whether you decide to insert a blank line after each item or not seems pretty self-explanatory, but I want to show you something. So if we insert a blank line here, each of our groups is now separated by a blank line. However, whether or not you'll see the blank line depends on how many fields are in your rows. So if I were to remove all of the date fields, leaving only the associates in the rows, we no longer get a blank line because it's only one row per group. So let's undo this. Let's get rid of this. We can also decide if we want to show grand totals, and if so, do we want to show it for just the rows or just the columns? And there may be times when you're only interested in showing the subtotals, so that would make the grand totals irrelevant to display. Likewise, you can also decide whether or not you'd like to display your subtotals and if you'd like to show them at the top or bottom of each group. Now keep in mind, whether or not you can move them to the top or bottom of each grouping depends on the report layout that you're using. For example, if you're in the tabular form, your subtotals will always be at the bottom of each group. For more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.